Yeah, they're like, all right, we're not going to give you guys any eye protection, but you don't need it. I mean, what's the chances of somebody coming in here in power armor and a bunch of sniper perks and just aiming for your eyes? Pretty low, right? All right, we'll check the new ones, see which new ones we have. Bonus rate of fire. This perk allows you to pull the trigger a little more faster. Each ranged weapon attack costs one less AP to perform. That's, at this point, not as great as it sounds. It's not terrible. Interesting. Because we can already take aim shots for five, so that means we can take two aim shots in a round. Now, granted, we could drop it down to four, and that would give us two extra action points, but that's not great. Like, that would allow us to move, and we could, if it was a tougher situation, we could do the thing where we hide behind a wall, we pop out one movement, take two shots, and then pop behind the wall. But we really don't need to do that at this point. I don't know if we'll see any more new perks. Oh, mental block. I say that is the ability to tune out any outside mental interference. You must have learned this talent from a passing guru or from a really late night at a bar. I don't know what that does. Empathy sounds like the one you need? No. I don't need the guilt. Somebody look at that up for me real quick. See what mental block does in Fallout 1, if you would, please. I'll look it up in a second if nobody else does. That's an interesting one. I wonder if that has something to do with, like, late game stuff. Because it doesn't actually tell you. Gives immunity against the master's psychic attacks. I was kind of thinking that was going to be what it was. Thank you, Lab Chimp. Should we metagame and grab that? I kind of want to grab it because honestly, there's nothing else that jumps out at me. The bonus rate of fire, like I say, is not bad, but it's not really great. We could tag something just for the shits of it, like big guns. We really don't have to wait for it. We'll do the mental block, why not? Okay, let's raise our big guns a bit. Why not? I mean, again, at this point, we're just putting points in whatever we want. I would like to play like a high skill point play at some point. Like, skill points aren't that great in the game, though. Like, it's not, because, you know, it makes you really good at a lot of things, which is nice, but not a huge deal. Not in this game. So skill points aren't, like, amazing. There's, like, a few skills you really need based on however you're going to want to play. Like small guns or energy guns or big guns. You know, speech, that kind of thing. I guess the skill, high int, high skill builds would kind of let you see all of your options. You look too much like Ian. ...220 critical to the eyes. Ouchies. But, like, it would give you all of your options, right? Like, you could get the speechcraft options, you get your science options, you get repair options. So, I guess a very high skill point build would let you really approach every situation multiple ways instead of dealing with it however you would normally deal with it. Which, my way is obviously the violent sway. Also, what's up, Labchip? How's it going? I think I had a drug addiction. Well, he's cured now. You're welcome. You're probably going to have to grab some ammo, though. Actually, we're at 232 still. Wait, did I look at the right thing? I did. Yeah, we're good. Oh, still doing Warframe? Nice. That's a game I've meant to get back into multiple times. Because I really like the gameplay. The jumping around and shooting shit is fun. See, you kill the vendor and they drop all their stuff. Wow. Amazing. Just like it should work. I did like playing the drug addicted character in our first Fallout 4 playthrough. That was fun. The melee drug addict character, because most of these games I completely ignore drugs, because it's like, I don't want to deal with the drug addiction part. It's just kind of a pain. You always have to have plenty of drugs to not be addicted. That kind of shit. But it was always, that's the cool thing about the Fallout series, is doing different shit, right? Like, you kind of have your ways you want to play, but then sometimes you go back, you're like, well, I'm going to try something different. And it, you know, was fun to use drugs and go completely ape shit and kill all the Brotherhood of Steel using using your fists. I'm here to see Decker, bitch. Fuck off. And if you don't like that, too bad, because you're just a smoldering pile of used to be human. God, how many stim packs do I have now? Now I'm just collecting them. 277. I'm going to open my own stim pack store. I'm sure Decker is going to be pretty pissed. Too bad. Hey, bitch. So you disposed of my second. I will take care of you myself. Will you, though? Actually, you know what? I want you to watch. I want you to watch this. I'm going to shoot all your boys in the groin. And your girls. They all getting shot in the groin. You're just going to watch. God, being able to take two aimed shots with this weapon is ridiculous. Really? You're the head of this criminal organization and your best weapon is throwing knives? Dexter's guard was critically hit in the groin for 85 hit points. She takes it like a man. That is to say, it hurts. He's like, oh! Stim pack in my nuts. Bye-bye, Decker. I rule this town now. Well, the Brahmin rule now. I shall bow to whatever wisdom they decide. Why are you not even caps on you? What an awful leader. You're garbage. Well, you were garbage, I guess. Yeah, Warframe seemed pretty cool. But it's on the list of things that when I retire in, you know, 30 years, if it's still around, I have to go and spend a lot of time. By then, I'll be like Warframe 4. And by the way, we're not going to necessarily go to every single area and kill everybody. I mean, as much as I would love to. It would just get boring after a while, I'm sure, to watch. Because there's like the Thieves Guild place. I don't even remember where the hell that is. Actually, that is in this town somewhere. But there is one place in particular we definitely will be going. Probably after we clean up the hub. She's like, I keep hearing people get melted, but I gotta keep playing my gambling games. At this point, not even might as well not even loot them. Kill them for no reason. This way it's meant to be. What are you guys doing in here? God frowns upon it, whatever it is. Just stayed in your damn room. The Brahmin will bring about a new paradise in this world. No baldies. Not even basic ones. Alright, where are the people hiding? In the streets, of course. Clicked too quick. Shot him in the groin. Sorry, buddy. I'll shoot you in the eyes instead. It's like an eye-shooting magnet over here. If only to have these Uzis when Katja was alive. Katja, we had Katja in the party for like 10 whole minutes. Hey, how's it going? Oh, you don't want to deal with my kind? Okay. Now you can just deal with the floor. Ooh, lizard on a stick. Or iguana on a stick. Hell yeah. Want me some of that action? I'm here for a load. Oh, we're still in combat. Ooh, I wonder if I can crack the safe. Probably trapped, I would imagine. Now, surely it's locked. Nice, unlocked. Wonder what doors I can't unlock at this point of the game. Or I've got like 110 lock picking. Ooh, 2000. Don't mind if I do. Ooh, granados. Buffout wouldn't be terrible to keep around just for weight, but... Bob's iguana bits are made out of people! Hell yes. I still want them, though. Delicious. Murdering the quote unquote innocent really takes it out of you. Like, shit. Tons of people to kill still. I wonder what happens if I try to talk to him or her. What happens if you unless you put your weapon away? Oh, for God's sake. She still might not. Oh, okay. I guess she will. You're a gun vendor. And you're pissing because I have my gun out? Shut up. Damn it. Damn it! Seems like I get the misses in bunches. Where are you going? Not a very brave guard here. Gonna go for the police? No, I don't think so. Think you're gonna go over there and send out an SOS? I don't think so. All right, let's see what we got back here. Please stay out of my stuff. No, I don't think I will. Dead people can't own property. The first rule of Brahmin law. I still don't know what these cat's paw are supposed to be. I'm guessing it's supposed to be a porn bag or something. I don't know. I'm doing the pee-pee dance here. Hold on. Damn. Grenades, I can't carry those all. Shit. I'll be right back. I gotta pee. We'll continue wiping out all these scumbags. Yeah, Warframe's especially impressive since it's free to play. And isn't it incredibly, like, generous with the free to play stuff, too? Ooh, Nuka Colas. Oh, wait, we're gonna try to get grenades. Damn. Alright, I'm gonna eat all this food. Because we've been playing months and hardly eaten anything. Increasing our radiation level, but that's fine. It's absolutely worth it. Oh, wrong thing, but. Everything is so weighty in this game. Howdy, police. Decker's finally blit dead. I never thought I'd see the day. Well, you won't see it for very long. Or anything, to be fair. Yes, so yes, I finally have killed... Oh, god damn it. I killed Kenny, and it says, oh my god, they killed Kenny! Those bastards! Wow. They do love their cultural... references in these games. I'm sure they made him name Kenny just so they could do that. So in 1997, how long had South Park even been running at that point? Like, surely not that long. I'm trying to think when I first heard of South Park. Because I actually did not like South Park when it first came out. Like, I saw, like, the first season or so, I was like, eh. Not that crazy about it. Just a bunch of swearing children. Hold on, guys. I'll get you out. I got your back. August 13, 1997. Wait, that's when South Park started? So, wait. So, they're referencing South Park really early on. I've been framed. You sure have. If but I still don't trust you. Because you've probably done some kind of crime. All these prisoners, empty. Hi guys, what's up? Your sentence has been served. What are you looking at? What am I looking at? What am I looking at? A future human puddle. Piece of shit. Talk to me that way? Are you out of your goddamn mind? Did you not hear what I just did in the cell next to you? Idiot. All right, Mr. Rom, thank you for coming out. Have a good rest of your day. We'll be ramping this game up today. There's some people up here, I think. What's our karma now? Negative 93. Nice. The Brian Fargo traders. Let's go clear them out. There's one other area. After we cleanse the hub, there's one last area we'll need to go through. And I'll try to make it quick. Damn. Nobody's taking over this place. You might want to take a little step outside. Try not to step in anyone else that you used to know. Because that has already happened. I have already taken over, pretty much. So I do hand the keys over to our trusted new lords and saviors, the two-headed Brahmin. All right, let's go to the next section. And there might be like a few people here and there we missed. That's fine. I'm not that worried about it. Oh, hey. Welcome in committee. How you guys doing? Y'all doing all right? Oh. All right, so that is helmet. Or the hat timer. Is up. So now I have to take my headphones off. Oh. Do I have my sniper rifle? No, I took it out because one lady's like, "Amp, I'm not gonna talk to you here in the gun vendor shop while you're armed with a gun. I know. But just trust me on this one." And yes, I know, like, in a real gun vendor's shop in real life, you wouldn't walk in with, like, a pistol flailing it around. I'm well aware. It's for the joke. The fuck? Get fucked. Gotta love when they shoot each other. Well, only 85 to the head. I mean, again, look at that range. That's pretty insane. We could put more in energy weapons that we could still 95% it, but it's really not necessary. Oof! That sure hurt. Getting shot with plasma bolts. Damn, you're a little sturdy boy, aren't you? God, the animation is sick. 1,500 from killing those guys. How close are we to level? If you had like 9,000 to level. Well, 8 and change. Damn it! That skag. Jesus. I want to be called a skag. Don't judge me or my skag lifestyle. Where's my blankie? I got your blanket right here, bitch. We would not be killing Harold. Harold is in that room. We will be leaving him alone. How are this kid? Gonna piss off. That was an odd child noise, but alright. 109? I don't know. I guess once you get one of these tags, like champion, I guess you never lose it and you never get the opposite, whatever the villain would be. I mean, probably villain. Because, I mean, we're pretty deep into the negatives at this point. So we should have gotten it by now. And I didn't think you lost them, but I did think you'd still get the other ones. Stop running around! You asked for this. Yeah. That's not going to go how you want it to go. Here's the Thieves' Guild, I think. Let's clean their asses up. I'm assuming they're still here. I know they said something about, we can leave at any time. Nope, they're still here. If you click really fast, you do the stanky leg. Looks like you should have stole some better eye protection. He's in there shitting his pants. Oh, fuck. I knew we should have moved. She had that dirty look in her eye. Ooh, look at all these grenades. Hey, boss, how you doing? Loxley, 200. Oh, you still got this. Cool, I'll take it. Didn't even get a chance to sell it off. Oh, well. Oh, that's the Thieves Guild dealt with. That's pretty much, I think the hub, that's pretty much the hub done, or damn near. I guess there was the water vendor guys down south, and the drug dealers. If you click, it kind of does the stanky leg. There you go. Yeah, see, he says, I don't want any trouble, so I think it would be best if you leave. I don't care what you think, bitch. Show this asshole how we deal with their kind, yeah. By getting your melted flesh all over me? Oh, no. Damn, even the junkies are getting up. They want a little piece of this. All right. They probably just want to die, though, to be fair. Oh. Second thoughts? Or are you just too stoned to know what the fuck's going on? Doing you a favor. No. Now where's the drugs? In this pile of man. So this was a guard. There's no way we're... We could probably go through a second playthrough and not go through all this. Wait, where's the drugs? He not had the drugs on him? Oh, that sucks. That's kind of lame. Unless sometimes it's in a container. So if it's not on them, it's sometimes on a container in the room that they're in. But it looks like this time, kind of fuck you on that one. Oh, wait. Here we go. I was going to say, that would be highly unusual. Oof, it puts us right at. Guys, gonna take these guys. Do these weigh anything? They might not. I might keep those just for the hell of it, just to get high on. Gets high on some roids. Alright, let's go to where the water boys are. We'll clear that out. And that should be the last section of the hub, I think. 119 negative karma. Could never climb out of this morale moral debt hole. Only the Brahmin can judge me. Oh, wait, what? Where's the... I hate when they put the door over here, because it's hard to see. Oh, I already wiped these guys out. I was ahead of schedule. Oh. Apparently word's not got around town yet. Julio. I guess somebody was in the way there? Oh, that's that stupid flower kid. It's like, take my flower! Take my flower! Take my plasma bolt. Now we're even. Let's go deal with these assholes. I mean, these assholes. The guard's like, nope. Don't pay me enough for this bullshit. Have one to grow on. That one guard would immediately left. Did he even take damage? He was already like, nope. I've heard about this bitch. I'd really rather not. I probably could have shot him. You did not, the guard life was not for him. Damn. Mercy, no French people in my house, bitch. Absolutely no Frenchies. Merci. Merci, fuck you. I don't know. It's the best I could come up with. Let's save another slot to you just to be safe. What did she have? Did I sell her that? What's she doing with a 13 water flask? I mean, I guess she did trade up to the vault. I must have traded her that at some point. I mean, it's theoretically they could have gotten them from the vault, because again, we open trade with them. Yes, the Brahmin are already all over the streets. One nice change with the fixed mod is in the base game, you can only move the camera so far away from your character, which I get, it makes sense. But honestly, for stuff like this where you're just trying to clean out the remaining living people, it's nice to be able to just scroll it wherever you want. All right, we're done with the hub. We have one last place to visit before we go to what I believe is the very last area of the game. We might not have, we didn't clear out the west side of the hub, but hey, I'm alright with that. I'm kind of over it. I think if we would have spread the wiping out a little bit more, it wouldn't have been as much, but again, I didn't want to lose the possibility of doing quests, which I guess I could have wiped them out. But I mean, even then we would have lost the ability to upgrade our power armor and stuff, right? So let's go back home real quick. Oh, hey, Mysterious Stranger. I forgot I even had that perk, to be honest. Yeah, he only shows up in random encounters, which definitely makes him far less useful, unfortunately. Not very useful at all, to be honest. Damn it. not very useful at all. Leather jacket, hunting rifle, and a spear. Get that shit out of here. And yes, once the mysterious stranger is dead, he's dead. Mole rats? You shit me right now? Do you have any idea? I am basically the equivalent of a group of Deathclaws. And y'all want to start shit? Wait, what's that shit on the ground? Oh, fruit? Oh, okay. Oh, that's right. I forgot that was a thing. So if you don't take any damage, you get extra XP. Which I think, again, that's one of those little details that I think more RPGs should do. Like, reward you for not taking any damage. That's another interesting thing I didn't really think about. Our base vault actually is built up instead of down. Like, most vaults are built down. I mean, it's technically both. But let's go say hi to our people. Fix my radiation. Do it. Oh, I will be careful. You scumbag. Even my own people can't be trusted. Was there somebody up here hiding? Even my own people can't be trusted. They'll eventually turn as well. Sons of bitches. You sent me out into the wasteland to die for you? I don't think so. So here we will encounter the only NPC in the game that I'm aware of that you cannot kill. Like, is literally unkillable. Wait, what? How's my aim blocked? And my back turned to her, I guess. These people had it coming. Sitting in here, let me do all the work for them. Talking shit about me. My daughter says she wants to be just like you, and I don't know how much I like that. Well, you know what? Fuck you. Now your daughter doesn't have a mom anymore. She'd grow up better off for it if she, you know, was actually going to grow up. We'll be not seeing that. Or she will not be seeing that. It's interesting they actually don't attack, though. Because you'd think at this point they would probably at least start running around and flailing. Weird, those vault suits aren't very protective against plasma blasts. Oh, somebody found their balls. Ah, shit. From way down the pathway there. Should have stayed hidden, Teresa. There's one dude over there. Now, if you do this in Fallout 2, you lose the game automatically. Which I remember pissing me off. Oh, there's two guys in here. Or two people. Now there's one. And now there's none. Where's Teresa's body? I want to see if she had something special, because she actually had a name. Nope. Worthless is all the rest. Just check in before we leave. Is there anybody over here? Nope. I think this is like the learning center. I think that's where there's nobody over here. But yet, a bajillion computers. Oh, the security guy. Mr. Like, don't talk to me with your weapon out. Yeah. Not an over-the-talking part of things now. Stop right there. Face the law. Yeah. Yeah, see, your primitive weapons aren't shit to me anymore. Gary. Or whatever the hell your name was. Look at this. Look at this primitive shit you were using. One person left in the vault. Well, two. Can I just talk to him?
What's wrong with you? You turned against us. I cannot allow that.
Yeah, well, I guess you have to find someone else to do your dirty work. Oh yeah, those guns hurt pretty bad, if I remember right. Well, okay. So he is literally unkillable. I have sat here in, like, back in the day, I sat here for hours, like, well, not hours. But I sat here shooting him over and over and over and over. He's apparently critical immune. Or just has an insanely high critical resist. I don't know if they like gave him like a million hit points, so like technically he could be killable potentially, but you can see we're not getting any crits. We're shooting him in the eyes and we're only doing like 6 damage. So this was the only, again, as far as I know, the only unkillable NPC in the game. I'm just kind of curious if we can ever get a crit off. I don't think we can. Yeah. Like, the max damage we've done is, like, 7. Alright. So we'll reload. Before we attack him. I do want to talk to him, though. I want him
What's
to bitch at me.
You?
Bitch. Surprised he doesn't aggro you immediately. That's kind of interesting. What was in here again? Oh, I hate that animation of... Oh, it's locked, eh? We can fix that problem. Wait, is there... Oh, there's one footlocker in here. Really? That was it? One shotgun? That's what you valued most? Was a shotgun and some... Oh, wait, there is another one. Maybe there's something actually worth a shit in here. Nope. Primitive. Absolutely primitive. I'm going to double check these lockers real quick, and now we're going to go to the cathedral, and that should be it, I believe. Which I think the cathedral's fairly involved, maybe? I don't remember exactly what's in there. I remember one thing in particular that's there. Something we've read about. Somebody whose journal we read. Actually, it was Dorian Gray. Or whatever that guy's name was. Remember the one, Harold's friend. think that was his name. Richard Gray. Dick Gray. How do I not remember that? All right, let's go. Let's go wrap this up. Put a bow on this masterpiece of an RPG. If I really did accentuate my ass with this power armor, didn't I? Got to make sure the ass looks good. When we first came through here, we were barely making it. Just had our pistol shooting rats. Now we're leaving with power armor and the most powerful weapon in the game. Arguably, I guess. I'm going to actually stop out here so I can save in case. In case we hit something negative, and let's go to the cathedral. I do love this game. Hopefully you guys, I really hope you guys have enjoyed this playthrough. I know the last part was maybe a little bit boring, just killing all the people. And like I said, we could have chopped it up a bit. But yeah, I didn't want to miss any quests. I was more concerned about you guys seeing more of the quests and whatnot. And getting more of the story and whatnot. Which I remember, I'm liking the story more than I remember. A small group of raiders. Ooh boy. This is not going to go well for you guys. Bunch of dumbass Ians. That bit the root? What? What does that even mean? Hey, bro. You still want to do this? You sure? Just kidding. It's too late. Almost got me, though. Y'all were super close. Maybe next time. The cult of Ians. One thing I'll say for the newer Fallouts, being like being able to go to first person, or you know, being more 3D, it's definitely more immersive. I get way more immersed into that kind of thing. So what's our karma now? 140. Not too bad. Hello, friend. It is good to see you. Put down your weapon. You are among friends here. Friends, eh? That's odd. I've heard a lot of bad things about you. Our enemies slander us. People are so easily frightened, especially when someone tells them what to do. But since I follow the Master and the Holy Flame, I don't have to be afraid anymore. The Master told me not to be afraid, as I spit all over the keyboard like a gross, gross old man. But there are rumors about mutant armies. Isn't it wonderful that the Master would unite humans and mutants? He transcends hatred and prejudice. Can't you see? This proves that he wants the best for everyone. Should I go in and be like, oh yeah, praise the Master. Let's do that so we can at least talk to him. Because I don't know if you can talk to him if you go in guns blazing. So let's say praise the Master. This has been a wonderful talk, but I am falling behind in my praises. Farewell. Praise the Master. Praise the Holy Flame. Let us sing the sacred songs. About the Heartland? We'll put our weapon away for now. Hey, haven't I heard about you? You killed all sorts of shit, haven't you? What brings you here? Where's the Master? That's Morpheus, our leader. He's up in the tower, I think. Who else is important in this joint? There's Lasher. Man, stay away from him. He's completely... I don't know if I can really describe him. Imagine that one person on Earth you don't want to know. Lasher's worse. So what's he done? What makes him so bad? There ain't nothing else to tell. And if you're smart, you don't want to know. Alright. A teenager. You're a strung out looking teenager. Damn. You're looking like 60 and you're like 15. You did it. When I grow up, I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna hunt you down and kill you. You killed them all. He sobs uncontrollably. Wait, who is this? How in the hell did you survive the nuke? Nightkin! I don't remember who you are. But now you're gone. Ah, damn it. I really want to see if I can talk to the master, though, even after we kill these nerds. I hope so. We might make a separate save, just in case, because I definitely want to talk to the master, because he is very unique looking, shall we say. And I don't know if this precludes us from doing that. And the way the karma, or at least like factions and stuff works, is typically if you kill some people of a faction, like everybody else knows it automatically. So they typically will attack on sight. So these guys will almost certainly attack on sight. Or not. The master will forgive your sins. Join us and be free. Praise to the master. The podium is normal, except for the children of the cathedral symbol engraved on the front of it. I'm looking for... Oh, it's you. I hope you're not here to kill me. If you don't mind, could you wait until after I finish meditating? You want to talk to Ton? Fine, but if I hear the word praise, I'll kill you. What's your problem, pal? I'm losing it in this zombie pit, and I don't need you helping me. Get the hell away from me. Hey, Velix. I'm the greatest of people. The most evolved of people. I think if I put the robes on, too, I think there's a mutant somewhere. I hear his idle animation. Let's save in a different slot. We're wrapping up. Velix, we're in the last area. We've fixed our karma, too.
I know who you are. You are the devil in woman's form, but your shape will not save you.
That's what people say about me all the time. Okay. I'm trying not to go too hostile here, because I want to... Oh, hello. I want to talk to the master, and I don't know how hostile you can be and still talk to the master. Yeah, I fixed our karma. See? It's now negative 141, and we're labeled as a child killer, but also a champion somehow. So now my karma is fixed. We wiped out basically everybody in the game.
What's your problem, asshole? Maybe I put you to sleep, shithead.
You better not try it.
Be quiet or I'll take out your vocal cords. To bark you like a dog. Now you want to get well or not?
Sure. You are a very weird doctor. I don't think I'd want this guy working on me, to be honest. Oh, there's Laura. Let's go talk to Laura. Lara Craft. Yeah, working
Hello,
while you're...
my sister. May I be of service this glorious day?
She has a face. Can I ask you a few questions about the children?
Oh, I'm hardly an authority. You should see Morpheus, the high priest. I'm sure he can help you much more than I. Is there something I can... Oh, I'm hardly
Damn
an
it.
Authority. You should...
Then what's the point of you talking to me? She might not talk because I'm killed a bunch of her people. Look, they attacked me. Like, literally, they attacked me. Outside. Something about blah, 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 you killed them all. I don't know. I mean, I probably did.
Greetings! How can I help you? I do hope that you will take a moment to realize the significance of any future decisions you make in regards to your soul.
Where can I get one of them fancy robes of yours?
Only trusted members of the cathedral are allowed to wear the holy purple.
We dropped off that robe in the hub, too, I think. We might go grab that again. Okay. We'll save here. We might run back to the hub real quick, because I know I put a bunch of stuff in that one drawer place. There's a computer over here. And backup generators from before the war. Okay. The large monitor, black and white only. The robed figure is reciting religious dogma at a feverish pace. The description is pretty good for being indoors without an antenna. Follow unity, pray. Follow unity, pray. So is this? Oh, this is Lasher. This is the guy they said to avoid. So who's Morpheus or whatever the fuck his name is? Now don't kill me yet. I need to meditate. Then you can kill me after I finish meditating. We'll wait. We'll just keep progressing. Because I think you can get in here if you have the robes on. I think you can get like additional info. Also, if I pick this, they'll probably attack. But don't pick lock on the flag. Don't mind me, folks. It's back here. Thought you guys were full of love and trust, but yet you're locking all these doors. You were unable to pick the lock. Really? Let's try that again. There we go. I'm surprised. Oh, hello. A nightkin, huh? We might end up reloading this, but... Ah, okay, they do attack. Yeah, I don't want to do that just yet. Also, I don't remember if Nightkin looked different in this game or not. Like I said, I didn't remember Nightkin being in the game. So let's go see if we can grab that robe real fast. If it's not there, I'll reload. Just so we can get back here a little bit quicker. Because I'm wondering if they'll talk to me a little different if I have the robes on. I meant to grab that while we were in the hub last time. Is that green? No. Oh, no, that's the boneyard. The boner yard? More. Okay, we've made that joke a thousand times. It's near the entrance. I think it was in this building. Knowing me, it would have been in this building, like in the desk or something. Yep, there it is. Not that I remembered that. Oh, shit. Really? That's the only stuff I put in there? God damn it. Why did I not keep the robe? What the... What are you doing here in my Brahmin utopia? Get the fuck out. Asshole. Why in the hell did I get rid of that robe? Probably because it was 10 pounds. Oh, I think I think I know. I think I dropped it off in the mutant base and then forgot it when I was leaving after I set the self-destruct. Oh, well. Really, boys? I don't have time for this shit. Fuck! Fuck is right. Or fucked is more like it. Good job. Plunder! What are you, a pirate now? Thanks! That was nice of you. I'm not even gonna loot them. Dumb shits. Alright. Yeah, man. Oh, wait, you're attacking now? Why? Will the others attack too, or what? Oh, they do. All right. But if I load this game instead. Yeah, sometimes the AI could be a little funky dooey, to say the least. We're probably going to just end up murdering everybody, especially since we don't have a robe. And if we kill this guy for his robe, everybody else is probably going to aggro by default. Didn't we just meet? Have you come to kill me? I know fathers aren't supposed to hug their sons, but I love you, Dad. What? Master, was this what I was supposed to become? What? There ain't nothing like a Dane. What's your favorite color, friend? Mine is milk. You're an idiot, Dane. They're going to kill you soon, and you deserve it. Weakling. Weakling. Mother, did you think they dropped the bomb? They did it with grace and such a blob. My name's Dane, and it's not Tom. Your poetry sucks, man. It sucks. Wow, okay, let's leave this guy alone. He's scary. There's a super mutant in here. Well, looks like violence is always going to be the answer. Because if I attack this guy, this dude would probably come over anyway. And I'm going to guess this guy's going to aggro. Yep. And our buddy Dane there is really going to fuck us up. Yeah, so the Nightkin do look a little different. They got the blue colored skin. I really didn't remember them being in this game. Thought that was something the later ones did. We're destroying your enemies without a scratch. Ooh, a stealth boy. We'll grab that. Yeah, because remember the Nightkin has something to do with the stealth boys? I forget how that works. Take that. Pass it out. Dad, damn it, I forgot it's 10 fucking pounds. That's fine. I'll try wearing the robe, but like I said, they'll probably know. I'll also try wielding no weapon. Again, it's not gonna matter. We're just gonna end up murdering everybody, so it's fine. It's all fine. Look at that beautiful power armor in my inventory, though. Oh, that's just his remnants. Okay, that's fine. Anything of interest in here? Nope. Yeah, we'll go back downstairs, but I'm imagining they're going to attack me on sight. Like I said, my big thing, though, is I want to make sure we can actually talk to the master. Hey, guys, what's up? I don't know. They're being cool. Oh, nope, never mind. Oh, no, I clicked on it. My bad. All right. Let's go try talking to her now.
Is there something I can help? Oh, I'm hard.
Nope, okay. All right, let's go talk to this dude. See if he'll say anything different. Again, probably not. In fact, he might attack me on sight.
Why have you come, initiate? You know that I do not like to be disturbed.
Nice rod you got there. Is that why they call you Lasher?
The rod is the holy instrument through which I instruct my charges. Pain clears the mind of evil thoughts and allows them to better comprehend the glory of the master.
I see. So the master's a pain?
I see no reason to converse with a fool. Away with you.
I just want to speak to the man in charge.
You should speak to Father Morpheus. He is in the tower, but it is unlikely that the Nightkin allow you to pass.
What can you tell me about the Nightkin?
They serve the Master. They bring the pain of healing to the world. Angels in the night who redeem the world by bloodshed.
Hey, that's what I do.
Curiosity is a foolhardy emotion, but doubly so when it comes to the Nightkin. This is your only warning. I have much to do. Away with you.
All right. Such a bummer. Wanted to talk. All right. I'll let it slide for now. Let's go into the tower. Let's see if we can talk to this dude. or if he attacks me on sight. Both are fairly decent possibilities. Oh, I saw a Nightkin over there. I hate when they attack when you talk to them. That's just weird to me. Like, why would they ignore you until you talk to them? These are just regular Nightkin. Blow their eyes out. Hit the back of their heads. Get wrecked. God damn it. Ow! Damn it, 73 hit points. I had 60. I got toasted. Alright, bitches. I'm coming back in. If I had full health, I'd have actually survived that. Let's just try not talking to that guy this time. I mean... Oh, we also don't have our power armor on. I kind of forgot about that. Damn it. Oh, we're actually over capacity because we took our power armor off. I'm going to read the books we have. Put the power armor on. Pick the books up. I'll read them later. Put your armor back. Yeah, there's... So you can get over-encumbered in this game if you do shit like that. But you don't get, like, weighed down. It just doesn't do anything. I'm trying to open the door. Why is all these computers rebooting? Ooh. So I can't grab any more. Seems to have locked up. These computers are shitty. Alright, we'll let those guys live for now, I guess. As much as I hate to.
I don't remember inviting anyone to my room, and yet I have a visitor. Why?
One of the brothers sent me up here.
I suspect you are a spy sent by the followers. I may be wrong, but I do not take chances.
We'll try again. So what I say, there's not a lot of options we can get. Who is this? Okay, so that is Morpheus. Okay. Well, you're feeling better, by the way, Velix.
I don't remember inviting anyone to my room, and yet I have a visitor.
I'm Chloe. What's yours?
I asked the questions, not you. Now, tell me what you are doing here.
I'm here to make you a deal.
I suspect you are a...
Yeah, I don't think our charisma is high enough to say, Master of Death, bitch, please. We'll try, like, one more dialogue option with him. But I think we're going to have to murder him. Who else is in here? Nightkin.
I don't remember inviting anyone to my room, and yet I have... I asked the questions, not you. I suspect you are a...
Okay. Not even going to put my other armor on just yet. Yeah, you're not going to see anything. Okay, now I will put my good armor on. These guys will probably hurt a smidge. He's like, he can't even see me. Oh, my eyes! Those who oppose unity must be swept aside. Okay. Oh, no. I'm doing my own kind of version of unity. Like, in my own way, I've got some unity going. Everybody has their own version of unity. Mine involves all humanity being destroyed and being run over, ruled over by low-level cows. A COC badge, two different ones. A badge in the shape of the Children of the Cathedral symbol. On one side, you notice bumps and indentations, almost reminding you of a key. Okay, so they both say the same thing. We'll take both. Luckily, they don't weigh anything, which is like the one time they're like, let's not make this not weigh anything. It's just a goddamn key. I wonder if we could do like a flamethrower playthrough in this game. Like, I don't feel like you'd be able to get enough ammo for it. Oh, nice. Electronic lockpick. The monitor flickers. Took a lot of science, a lot of years of schooling to learn. Tesla armor? What is this? I do not remember that. Actually, I kind of do now. The shining armor provides superior protection against energy attacks. The three Tesla attraction coil rods disperse a large percentage of undirected energy, such as plasma and laser rifle fire. Unlike the basic metal armor, it strongly resembles the armor is actually pre-war military design. It's in good condition. I didn't even remember that being a thing. Like I said, I kind of sort of do now, but interesting. We don't have to wait for it. I do want to. I would like to kind of see what it looks like. It probably looks like regular armor, to be honest. Let me try dropping a few things real quick, just to look at it. Damn it! I forgot to lockpick it. Open it. Oh, this is like regular armor. Let's see. It's actually still worse laser protection slightly than the power armor, which we also have the treated. It's got a little electrical symbol on it too. That's neat. But we'll put it back. Put it back where we found it. All right. We'll put our robe back on, but I don't think that's going to help. I'm guessing they'll all be fairly pissed at us now. Which would be a real shame, because then I just have to murder them all. What? I mean, he was probably going to attack later. Probably. And what's a few more Nightkin? That's not going to piss them off. I already killed a bunch. They're already angry. Why is it covered in gore? Well, see, here's the thing. I have been preaching the gospel of the master, and I mean, we do babble on about, you know, teaching through bloodshed and shit, so I think it makes perfect logical sense that maybe I had to kill a few motherfuckers to do the thing. So I'm guessing I probably could use the symbol on this thing, because I'm guessing there's like a stairs back here, I guess. Damn it, it's a goddamn door here. Or maybe not. Oh, I bet I place it into that. I might place it into this. Because remember, there's a vault Sasha. It's a dog named Sasha over there. All right, I gotta pee. I'll be right back.
We'll look around. We have to go break into that thing in the back.
Let's go break into this back. I'm pretty sure it's not back here because like it won't even let me combine it. It says action aborted as soon as I try it. Let's go back here first. Oh, whoops. Oh my god. Like what? The fuck are you doing? Lockpick the door. Yeah, this is definitely a very high lockpick lock. Or lock skill. Oh, I don't have the... Oh, there, I was gonna say, what the fuck? How do I not have that? Oh, so it doesn't help with regular locks. Okay, I thought it did. Yeah, you're obviously not normally supposed to do it that way, I don't think. I want to see what happens. Obviously, this guy's going to attack us most likely. No, he didn't. I guess because we're wearing the robes. Bunch of flowers, an emotion sensor. Ah, there is stairs down here. So I wonder what you're supposed to use the symbols on. To open the door. Oh well. So I'm guessing the entrance to the vaults is down here. Because remember they said that it was built close to a vault. Not necessarily over it, but... Big Book of Science. Ah, shit, we're already... Maximum capacity. Anyway, it says I can't pick that out. I'm just trying to search the bookshelf. Here we go. I don't know why it does that. You cannot pick up the bookshelf. Well, I'm not trying to. I'm just trying to search it. You took the book, put it down, examine it, and put it back on the shelf. The shelf itself seems very sturdy. The bookshelf is filled with religious and philosophical books. Is this going to be the old... We need to put a specific book into it. Or a symbol now. I mean, that doesn't make a lot of sense. Yeah, I do not remember this at all. Observing it doesn't do anything. The religious and philosophical books. So I'm guessing... Oh, what the... Wait, why are you coming out now? I am a worshiper and I am lost. We are not allowed down here. Only servitors and higher are allowed here. Return to the cathedral proper. Why did you pop out now? That's super weird. I don't know what I did to trigger that. What the fuck? Oh, have we seen one of those at all yet? I don't think we have. What is this? I don't know, it doesn't tell me. Oh, it's a centaur. Interesting. Yeah, have we? I don't know if we've actually seen one this playthrough. Oh, God. Ugh. You gotta hear this thing queefing on us. Get out of here, please. You're gross. Nice. Yeah, I still don't know how we were supposed to open that. Now it's closed back, which is fine, I guess. Got a level. Sure, big guns, why not? Why not? Yeah, that's a very weird sequence. I don't know how you would normally do that. Because the door just opened. The guy came out. Maybe he just comes out after a while. Like, if you mess with a bookshelf, he'll, like, come out. That's weird. Well, we found the vault. And I'm pretty sure the master will talk to us regardless. So we're fine on that. Should be, I think. Gong. Now that we're down here, we can read our books too. A lighter? What the fuck? Why do you have a lighter? Yeah. Yeah, our small guns is high enough that we learn nothing from the book. Which is fun. We have a lighter, it's so random. And a box of noodles? A box of noodles? Why? We got this weird shit. How are we on ammo? God, this would be a horrendous time to run out of ammo. Ooh, Rexy, it's sort of kind of low. Relatively speaking. But these guys are going to give us plenty of it, I imagine. Is this the computer you can... I don't think that will help. Nope. Yeah, I think if you have a high enough science, you can do something pretty major here, I think. But ours is only 66, which, I mean, considering you put 0 points in the science, leveling up, it's not too bad that it's that high, because you get so many books. Okay, I was going to try 3 times, and if I don't get it, I don't get it. Wait, what is that? Is that a... just a bag. I do actually like the layout that the vaults are laid out the same. I know I said that before, but again, I think it makes sense. Now, within reason, obviously, like, some vaults are going to be going straight down, some are going to be up, And then depending on the rock formations and stuff, it's going to be less possible to build certain ways and blah, blah, blah. Oh, God. What the fuck's going on in here? We'll try the rope thing. I'm pretty sure at this point that ship has sailed. A sleeping mad scientist. They're not sleeping. They're awake. Leave them alone and get out. No one is allowed in here while they're sleeping. Oh, cannot rest at this time? Come on. Hey, yes, little sister. What is it you need of me? Where's the master guy? I say, praise to the unity, brother. You sound like you do not believe what you say. Could this be true? Or have you left the path of righteousness? You mistake the tremor in my voice for fear when it is actually a cold of some sort. Oh, for fuck's sake. They really like to get you on the dialogue shit on this. Let's go try to talk to this guy. I'm not wearing the... I forgot the switch. Sorry. I have a feeling if I just say basically anything, with our low charisma, it's going to end up in fighting. Okay. What are these people saying? A normal-looking human female. She's wearing a crown. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. Oh, for fuck's sake. Their name... Isn't this your home? My home is... Yeah, it's here. This is my home. She jumps up and down. I'm so happy. You can't believe how happy this makes me. I think I'm going to punch the wall for a while. Okay. She seems okay. Gideon, also wearing a crown. Jason is a living god. Only the nullified may pass. Who's Jason? Jason? Who's Jason? Are you the experiments I'm looking for? Flim! Insubstantial development. Communication. Null. End of death. Okay. I'm tired of living. Me too. The asphalt shall run red. I will crush. What are you talking about? Only the powerful can pass, but they will be kept from passing. But I had to see the master. Gideon. Gideon speaks that way. Okie doke. Well, you guys... Can I close this door back? Because I don't think I ever want them to talk again. Yep. For their own safety and the safety of everyone else, I think it's best that they stay locked up in there. You see a computer. There are some pieces of something on it that might be human flesh. You fiddle with the computer for a while, but you cannot get past the security system. What's up, Smiley? How's it going? Hey, we should be able to fix these. I think. Is it repair? Oh, that's right. Wait, these ones... Oh, that's right. Wait. How do we get by these? I forget. Or was it the red ones? I thought we could repair these and get through them. Prisoner stares blankly at the wall. The prisoner stares at you and drools. Your kind is repugnant. Do not speak to me. You don't have the right to speak to me like that. I have no rights and couldn't care less. Go away. Leave us alone. Leave us alone! So these people don't seem to be doing great. Goo. Some sort of Noxious biological goo. Okay. Alright, let's go down to the next level. Why am I out of my armor? I'm wearing this so that they won't attack. I'm just trying to get a little bit more dialogue. Because they think I am one of their peoples. While I'm in this armor. Unfortunately, my charisma is really shit, so I think if I talk to them at all, they tend to get pissed. I'm trying it just to try it, but what's with that master guy? You're obviously I think if I had higher charisma, I could actually talk to them, but because I don't, they instantly attack me. But I can kind of get around. Not that I would mind killing them all, because God knows I do like to murder these guys, but this whole area is why he wanted to kill Charlie Adam in Fallout 3. What do these guys have to do with Charlie Adam? Necessarily. You see a super mutant leader. Oh, his name is Vicious. Hey. Ooh, Hero. Oh, I can't grab it because I'm in my robes. Shit. All right, so I can't grab anything, but it's good to know what's in here. Y'all, let me grab those because I'm overburdened. Actually, maybe we'll get that. Nope. Is there a second? There's the other elevator. All right, let me see if I can talk to him without him doing anything. The will of the master prevails. What news do you have for me? The war goes well. Your manner, but oh, for fuck's sake. Okay. We'll try to go in here. Actually, yeah, we'll try to go in here, talk to these guys real quick, which again is probably going to result in the same thing. We do the work of the master. Yeah, that's what I hear. All right, none of you guys are named. Do the will of the master. Yep, okay. How do you use these computers? They've got flesh bits all over them. How does it even work? Now, these guys might attack as soon as I open this. Or as soon as I lockpick it. How do you lock an elevator door? How does that even make sense? I wonder how you would get through this without lockpick skill. I'll also use all those save slots. Computer console. A live nuclear warhead. This is a nuclear bomb. It looks very dangerous just sitting here. The nuclear access computer. The computer looks very secure. There is a slot for a strangely shaped key, which we don't have. There isn't even reason a point to come in here. Not yet. I'm trying to find the damn master. All right, so there's no point for this. Not yet. Where the hell is he? Oh, there's a door. They didn't see it. Because there's multiple ways you can deal with the situation. But I want to make sure we see the master, though. That's why I'm being, like, cautious about stuff. Seems like a nice place to be. I'm glad I'm here. And I'm potentially not scrolling up. Dear God, what the hell?
So what shall it be? Do you join the Unity, or do you die here?
Join.
Die.
Join.
Die.
Let's try this one. If you can prove to me that your Unity is the best course for humanity, then I will help you.
I don't have to prove anything to you.
Prove.
I can't know you represent the best future unless you prove it to me.
Very demanding for one in your tenuous position. But I can
respect
your needs.
So tell me.
The Unity will bring about the Master Race.
Master!
One able to survive, or even
thrive,
in the Wasteland. As long as there are differences, we will
tear ourselves apart,
fighting each other. We need one race.
Race!
One goal.
Goal!
One people to move forward to our destiny. Destiny.
And yes, this is Richard Gray, I think his last name was. That was a friend of Howard's, or goddammit, Herbert? God, I can't remember now. Want a sound pack of this phone? One of the voices that's being used sounds really familiar. Because it's multiple. Harold, yes. Thank you, Dehydride. Door to Super Gore Corridor. Yes, that is a good name for it. I like it. It rhymes. Richard Gray. Yes, Gray. Thank you. That race being the mutants, of course.
Of course.
Mutants are best equipped to deal with the world today.
Who else?
The ghouls?
Please.
Normals?
They brought nuclear death to us all.
He's not wrong.
This will be the age of mutants.
Mutants.
But what about those who oppose you?
They will be
punished
for their insolence.
You mean to kill them all? I mean, I've kind of already started that.
Of course not. Most will be offered a chance to become a mutant.
Those who deny this
opportunity
will be sterilized and
let go. Those that resist will be
executed.
I'm not big on being executed. I'm joining.
Excellent. Your talents will be
useful.
But first, you must tell me everything about your vault.
Why?
I will conquer it and turn all those pure strain
humans
into mutants. They will give me the army I need to bring
peace to the entire Wasteland.
I think this is going to get us the same cutscene we saw earlier, but he's in for a bad experience because everybody's there dead except for one. But sounds reasonable. Let's do it. Yeah, we'll watch it again. But obviously, we'll not go with this as the end. Though, I do appreciate, God, I'm sorry it's so fucking loud. Don't struggle. Don't struggle, just absorb it. Become the super mutant you were meant to become. I like watching Vault 13 get their comeuppance again. I love that. I need to capture that for a clip or something. I love that walk animation. Hey, Overseer, what's up, bitch? What's funny is they killed them all, but really they should have been capturing them, right? Because they want to make them into, because they're prime normals, right? All right. The hairs on the back of your neck rise. I didn't see this last time. The hairs on the back of your neck rise. You feel something from the corridor ahead. The bile rises as you recognize the mass of flesh ahead. A human parts in the wall itself. The worst part is that it is moving, calling to you. Oh, he's got robots in
so
here, too.
So what shall it be? Do you join the Unity, or do you die here?
Join.
Die.
Join.
Die.
Oh, there will be death today, but not mine. I've got a plan.
Oh, please. What sort of
plan
might that be?
I'll kill you, and that'll make it difficult for you to continue, right?
You think you can destroy me?
Destroy
me?
Yes. Oh, he did exactly how many hit points I have. I guess we can go ahead and switch back to the power armor. Because I was going to switch during combat, but if he wants to be that way. We can play that game. Actually, does the plaster still do more damage? Yes, it still does. Oh yeah, so wait, what how would this be different
so
without the nullifier?
Do you join the Unity or do you die here?
Join.
Die.
How about you
join.
Die then I leave?
You think?
That brought me down to 60 points that time, bitch. The question marks. The hard line, the spine, tendrils. Shoot him in the question marks. 48 hit points. He's probably got a ton. Yeah, he's got a ton. Shoot him in the other question marks. I'm going to ignore the robots because he'll probably shoot them himself. He's doing a lot of no damage. You were critically hit for no damage. I hate when that happens. Ooh, 124 to the eyes. Let's try that again. Oh, hey. How are you doing? Severely wounded. Probably better than this guy's about to be. Nighty night. Thank you for killing your own robots. We'll need the heal. Master's like, whoa, whoa, hold up, hold on. 329 stim packs. Holy shit. I think we're good. Yeah, we found the alien blaster fairly early. We still use the plasma rifle more just because of the range, but let's go ahead and reload it while we're in here. And he kills the other one. Thank you very much. Oh, there's a big guy back there, too. You know what? Just because. I don't really need to, but I want you to see this falling down all around you. Yeah, I know. I could do this all day, bitch. Got nothing but time on my hands. Well, that and an alien blaster that will fuck you up. How low are you at this point? Almost dead. Nice. There we go. Now I'm the master. I'll help. Alright, so we just save in a different thing because now we have a countdown timer. You can also set the countdown timer. If you have enough high enough science, maybe. I think you can get the key. And you can set that bomb off, that nuclear bomb. You can set the timer and then leave, and you never even see the master. I love shit like that, by the way. We might have time to murder these guys. The timer does still go down while you're in combat, which is kind of a bitch, but it also makes sense. We have... good job hitting yourself, dummy. Oh, the scientist actually did some decent damage there. Heal up. Why don't I have any companions? Because they get murdered very quickly. We had Ian for a long time. But, rip Ian. He was a good boy. Bam! Mr. Handy critically missed and crippled his right arm. Love watching them cripple themselves. Actually, no, switch back. Yes, Ian survived for way longer than he should have. But once we got to the mutant base, that was pretty much all she wrote. We can tolerate this. Bam! That's how you clear a room. It took a little bit of damage, but that's fine. This was back when power armor was actually insanely badass. Like, the power difference between power armor and, like, the next best thing is pretty huge. Yeah, Ian did surprisingly good melee damage. I was shocked. Get blowed up. How are we on time? 197? Probably okay still. Probably. This Jinx run has been fun, though. Ooh, you bitch. I love watching the enemies missing and knocking themselves down. Oh, for fuck's sake. This is not the time to miss 95% crits, please. Alright, you little bitch. I'm gonna solve that goddamn problem right now. Alright, heal up to max. Damn, 3200 XP. Holy shit. Should have came here to farm XP. We'll save in a different slot again. We keep using up every single save slot, by God. As much as I would like to kill all these guys, we're in a little bit of a hurry. Oh shit, I don't know how to get out. That could be a problem. Oh, I think I can just... Oh, no. I think I was supposed to inspect that wall before. I think that's what I was supposed to do. I still don't know why that guy came out. But he basically... Him doing his job basically killed the master. Who he's so in love with. Oh, I love you, master. You're so great, master. Touch me, master. I mean, we could just run for it. We might have to, just because of the number of people to kill. Crippled his right arm trying to attack me. Good job, nerd. much more fun way to do that. That's how I took out all the traitors in the hub. I waited until they all gathered around me, and then I just blew them up. You must receive discipline. Ooh, okay, Daddy. Relax. I want to make sure we're full health so that no bullshit happens at the end. Bitch. Do we have any more rockets? Okay. Grenades it is. Later, haters. Honestly, the best death animation in this game, though, was the corporal, the lieutenant or whatever. He had the bloodiest one. Oh shit! God damn it! I meant to hide my. Well, we're fine. It's gonna be loud. Sorry. I'm intentionally trying to duck out of it. I can't hit the button to hide the cam or it'll skip.
The death of the master was the first major step towards ending his mad dream of conquest and enforced peace. But it is the destruction of the vats that neutralizes the mutant threat. Without the ability to create more mutants and enforce their harsh brand of justice, the mutant armies flee to the east, beyond the no man's land. The mutant attack on Necropolis spares none of its ghoulish inhabitants.
Yeah!
After the mutant armies advance, they leave a truly dead city behind them. With Aradesh dead and Tandy missing or killed, Shady Sands needs a new leader. After several elections, they find they cannot be governed by a single person and create a guiding council. Shortly afterwards, the raiders regroup and attack Shady Sands, burning the small community to the ground.
I did that, actually.
The Brotherhood of Steel helps the other human outposts drive the mutant armies away with minimal loss of life on both sides of the conflict. The advanced technology of the Brotherhood is slowly reintroduced into New California, with little disruption or chaos.
I killed them all!
The Brotherhood wisely remains out of the power structure and becomes a major research and development house. With your assistance, old Harold brings the ghoul population of the hub into equality with the humans. The two sides work together and the hub prospers. Old Harold is still alive, as far as anyone knows.
Yes, he is.
The Desert Raiders eventually regroup and manage to terrorize small communities in the years following your adventures.
Yeah, I killed everybody in the Brotherhood of Steel, including Rhombus.
Your involvement with the various places and people of the Wasteland is well documented by future historians. Only a single question remained unanswered. What happened to you?
You've done it. That's wonderful, amazing. I'm so proud of what you've accomplished, what you've endured.
Yeah, I killed everybody in the Brotherhood of Steel, which it's kind of lame that they didn't account for that. that they're like, oh yeah, they even show, was that Rhombus? It shows one of the major Brotherhood guys as if he's still alive. I finally made up for 20 something years ago when I couldn't get into the goddamn supply room to kill the people in there. So this time I got in there, literally murdered everyone in the Brotherhood of Steel. Also, I did intentionally leave Harold alive because I like Harold. So I left him alive. But he was just about the only person alive in the hub. And I wiped out all the people in Vault 13, except him, because he's unkillable. Or is he?
There's no way that people of the Vault can ever thank you enough for what you've done. You've saved all our lives. Who knows? Maybe even saved the human race. That makes the rest of this even harder.
All right, I'm going to turn it up a little bit because some of the dialogue is really low. I want to make sure this is a little bit louder. Please don't. God damn it. God bless you, old games. Because it's not refreshing.
Everyone will want to talk to you. Every youngster will look up to you and want to emulate you. And then what? They'll want to leave. What happens to the Vault if we lose the best of a generation? What if we are the only safe place in the world? You just gave us back all these lives. I can't take the chance of losing them. I've made a lot of tough decisions since I took this position, but none of them harder than this one. You saved us, but you'll kill us. I'm sorry. You're a hero, and you have to leave.
Okay, well, I'll just see myself out. Bitch. Eat a dick. That was automatic, by the way. I did not do that. It's based on your karma. If your karma is negative, you kill him. Oh, this is new. Be the continue playing. All right, I think it's new. Play movie sequence and credits. All right, let me cut myself out here so I can actually see it. Another iconic scene. Pretty ballsy of the Fallout Fix people to put their names first in the credits. That's pretty ballsy. So I did use the fixed patch, CB Liberty. I don't think in the original you could choose to continue. So yeah, I think that's a fixed thing, I think. So when I installed Fixed, I picked the option to go with the Puritan version. So my version of Fixed really mostly fixed mods or fixed bugs, reintroduced things that were removed later, like removing kids from the game on the Steam version. I think they added some minor options so you could make your companions get the fuck out of the way, so that they wouldn't soft block you in rooms and shit. Man, they do got some balls, don't they? Putting all the mod credits first before the game credits. I can't say I agree with that. That's kind of pretentious to do. To replace the credits with your own. Or, I mean, I'm sure the other credits are there too, but putting them before the developer's credits is pretty shitty. Not gonna lie. I mean, I appreciate that they put all this work in, for sure. And I think they should put their name in the credits, for sure. But putting them before the developers, you got some balls. I mean, yeah, I guess nobody watches the end of the credits, but there might be something. And of course, we're probably going to get content ID, so this is probably going to be getting muted anyway. Nah, the game would still exist without them. It definitely would. Like, this game would be, it's still playable with a Steam version. And I, again, I appreciate all the extra stuff they added as well. But it's like it doesn't work, right? Like, it's not like it's some older games, like, or that you couldn't even find. Like, for example, a game that I've wanted to play again is Wolverine, the Wolverine game. That was based off the movie that was actually good, but you cannot find that shit anywhere. So like modders, well, I guess it would be a modding thing, but anyway, you get what I mean. But yeah, I wanted to do some, I looked at some possible custom, because you can also do custom with fixed, but I just went ahead and picked the Puritan, because I wanted to show mostly how the game was originally. Right, I wanted to show how, like, mostly how that experience was back in 97. Obviously with some tweaks. Like, I'm fine with stuff like making it so that you can tell the companions to get out of your way, because you can soft lock yourself, right? Because if you get stuck, like if you walk somewhere like a bathroom or something, and Ian or whoever blocks the way, they won't move, so you like have to kill them or reload. And they did add that in Fallout 2. In Fallout 2, there's like a push command, and you can push the companion out of the way. You didn't save for 10 hours? How the hell? Were you on console? Man, I don't know how people do that. I save all the time. The only time I got bit by that was Subnautica. Subnautica, that fucked me. Because I'm not used to survival games you having to save, right? Like, survival games tend to save constantly, right? They're kind of like Dark Souls. They tend to, just like Dark Souls, they save all the time, right? So, good lord. All right, credits. We're good. But I just hit down to see if it would go faster, but I know that was asking a lot for a game this old. But, yeah, in Subnautica, I assumed the same thing. I thought it saved, or at least had an autosave. And at the time, Subnautica did not have an autosave, and which was unacceptable. It's unacceptable not to have an autosave in a newer game. And the devs, like, tried to justify it with some bullshit, but they eventually did add an autosave, because it was moronic that they didn't have one. Like, that was just flat-out stupid on their part, not to have an autosave. Just really dumb. But anyway, so yes, that was Fallout 1. Very pleased that we could finally play that. And we will keep streaming, by the way. The stream's not over. So if you guys on Twitch want to hang out a bit, we might take a small break because I am starving. I like to eat a little bit of something. But yes, we did talk to the master. But yes, you actually can beat that without ever talking to the master. You can go in. I think that's how the speedrunners do it. I think they go to where the bomb is with like a high science or whatnot and trigger the bomb and then just leave. But yes, I'm very glad we get to finally play that. I still think this game holds up. Obviously, there's a lot of things missing from this, like, you know, party management. You can't like equip your party members. You just kind of have to hope they equip the best things. They won't equip armor for some bizarre reason, stuff like that. There's not, the quest log is kind of ass. It's not really kind of ass. The quest log is ass. But I still think it's a lot of fun to play. No. Thank you, Brian Fargo. But I'm surprised they didn't replace Brian Fargo's name from the front. By God, this is our game now. Sorry, I don't know. I'm just floored by how how pretentious you have to be to put your own credits at the top. Anyway. But yeah, I still think the game is great. I still think if you can, if you have experience with CRPGs like this, or if you're willing to learn and do a little bit of research, like I said, you don't have to go crazy with it. I think if you read the manual and do some basic search, I think your first character should be combat focused though, because you can't just talk your way through everything in the game. Like you can't do planes, like a Planescape Torment type thing where you just talk your way through the entire game and never get into combat. But so those, it's kind of like Vampire Bloodlines, right? Where Vampire Bloodlines, you can kind of talk your way to some stuff, but there are forced boss fights. And if you don't have your combat up to snuff, or if you don't have companions with you who are well armed, then you're kind of screwed. Icewind Dale. I never actually played those. Back in the day, after Baldur's Gate, I was so disappointed with Baldur's Gate. Back when I played it, when it came out, I didn't touch any of those other games either. But yeah, I still think this game is fantastic. I'm glad we did it too, so I could see some of the lore again, because I really did not remember any of the lore. I mean, it had been 20-something years since I played this to completion. So it was nice to see the lore again. I didn't realize that Harold's buddy was the one who became the master. I also had forgotten this whole thing with the FEV was the entire reason the super mutants. It wasn't radiation. Like, that's just coincidental that it kind of happened around the same time, sort of. And that the super mutants wouldn't have existed even if the bombs wouldn't have dropped, because they were, you know, doing the whole FEV thing, and they were like right at the brink of starting to create them when, you know, the nuclear war happened. And then Richard Gray got knocked into it and basically went nuts and became the master, which I don't quite know why he was different. I think they might have explained it in the data logs why he didn't just become a super mutant. He became like a super mutant. And I know in his logs they talk about it a little bit, but I don't really remember why he... I know he like experimented more, like he injected himself with other stuff. So maybe that's why he just became this weird giant lump of growing flesh and a talking head with multiple voice actors. But no, he got knocked into it. He got knocked into it, because remember, that's how he got infected, right? Because he was with Harold. The like the swinging crane thing knocked him into the vat. Harold watched him get knocked into the vat. And then Harold like just escaped or whatever. So he did get knocked into it. But yeah, it's, I don't know. But like I said, it causes a problem, because later on, super mutants are all over the place. And if FEV is what causes the super mutants, then they shouldn't be around. And they're sterile. So yes, you'd have had the existing super mutants who survived the explosion somehow running around. But when they died, they were dead because they couldn't reproduce. So I'm assuming they just changed the lore. I'm assuming they made it so that, well, okay, that's not the only way you can make super mutants. Or maybe they made it so there was more FEV, all of it. I don't know. But anyway, the lore was pretty fun. They explained it in New Vegas. And two, the other super mutants tend to be stupid. But the stupid super mutants, I think, were more due to converting people who were already radiated. And most people obviously are radiated, which is why they were trying to grab the Vault Dwellers. Because the Vault Dwellers would not have been radiated, and they would have become the smarter super mutants. Yeah, and hell, even maybe two. I think maybe even as soon as two, they just threw away the whole FEV thing, because I'm pretty sure there's super mutants in the second one. I don't really recall. And the second game happens, I want to say like 60 or 70 years after this Fallout. Because there's a couple characters that we'll see again in Fallout 2. And yes, I will be playing Fallout 2 this year. I don't know when. Probably after I play the Subnautica Below Zero. So I would say month and a half to 2 months from now. 50 to 65. Yeah, that sounds about right. So it's been quite a while. So a lot of the super mutants would have just died out from either just, you know, age or, well, or just, you know, random hazards. But anyway, I'll wrap up. Thank you guys for doing this or watching both on Twitch and YouTube. Twitch, again, don't go anywhere. We're not ending the stream yet. But I'm definitely glad you guys came out. I very much wanted to do this, like I say, for a very long time, since day one of starting the channel and 10 years ago. And I had a lot of fun with it. I hope you did too. And I will see you guys next time.